Hello, everybody. It's Tommy. In the last video, we have two questions. One is that if you want a user input an integer, but he or she input a float, that will make the program error. How do you fix it? And the second question is that write a program with two number variables, and your program can distinguish the number is odd or even. If the number is odd, then the program will output n. Otherwise, the program will output y. And you have two number, so you will four combination. NN, NY, YN, and YY, and please write a program. Okay. And this video, we will tell you how to use Python to solve the two questions. For the first one, like this one, if you want to the user input integer, but if or she put a float, then your program will get value error, and the program will stop here. And the easy way to fix this one, you can put a float function between integer and the input, like this one. Okay, like this one, int float input. Okay, and then when the user input a float, then the input will convert the float to the string, because this is this function do. And then this will be the string. The float can convert the integer to the float, and that integer is the content of the string is the float, okay, or float number. So the float can convert that string to the float, and then you can use integer int this function to convert the float number again and to the integer. Okay, so you will see the program will like this. Okay, float, string, float, and the integer. Okay, so the output will like this one. You will get the integer, and this integer is the maximum integer that is smaller than this float. Okay, so this is the first question solution. And for the second question is this one. Write a program and it's with two number variable, and if a number is odd, the program will output n, otherwise the program will output y. And these are the example, like 1 1 you will get nn, 1 2 you will get ny, and so on. And the question is about if the x equals to 103 and the y is 29802, what's the result? And for the x is 378 and y is 872, and what's the result? Before we type the program, and we can think the result in our mind. For the first one, we will think this will get ny, because it's odd even, so ny. And for the second one is yy, because even, so we think this will get yy. Okay, and there are many ways to solve this question, and the following is one way. For example, you can let the variable is fixed, like number 1 or x equals to 103, and number 2 equals to 29802, and then the program will automatically execute these two numbers, and the user do not type anything. Okay. And for the program to distinguish number is odd or even, you can use the remainder. Number 1 divide 2 and his remainder is 0 or 1. If the remainder is 0, then this is even. Otherwise, it is odd. And then you can use the next structure like this one to solve the question. Or you can use the logistic operator AND to answer the question. In next structure, you will like the program like this one. This is the next if, and then another if. And if you use the logistic operators, and you will get AND between here, like the number 1 divide 2 equals to 0, AND number 2 divide 2 is remember equals to 0. Okay, and you use a logistic operator, and you need type 4 combination. Okay, and this is the next structure. Okay, number 1 divide 2 is remainder equals 0. If this is true, then this number 1 is the even, otherwise it is odd. And then similar, we do the same thing to number 2. Okay, so then you can get this one is true, and you will get yy, 2 even number. And then true false, you get yn. And this is for the condition 1 is false, so we will jump here. Okay, false true ny, false nn. Okay, so for the 1 0 3, this is condition 1 is false. Then we go to here, and then the number 2 is even. Then we go to here. Okay, so you get yny. Okay, and you can copy this code for the second number, 378 and A72. Okay, then you will get yy, because even, true, and then you get yy. Okay, yy. Okay, this is use the variable, and the variable is fixed. And if you want to let user input, then you can modify the first two line to like to input. Okay, and here we suppose user will type integer and no float here. Okay, so you change this one, then you can get the result here. Okay, and this is the answer for the two questions in the last video. And this is the end of the video.